Welcome friends. So let us continue with our session on algebraic identities. So far we have done squares of binomials and trinomials. Now in this session we are going to see what is a cube of a binomial. So before we start, we must understand what a binomial is, and we already know it. It is x plus a form of x plus y, x minus 2y. So there are two terms in a polynomial, then we call that polynomial as a binomial, right? So now what is a plus b cube? So let us say if you don't know any identities, then fundamentally we could have done this a plus b and then multiplied this a plus b with another a plus b and finally third a plus b, and then one by one you would have expanded this and then multiplied like that, right? No, but now we already have some knowledge of identities, so hence a plus b whole cube can be written as a plus b whole and a plus b whole squared, isn't it? So power 1 here is power 1 and here is power 2. How? Because a to the power m into a to the power n is simply a to the power m plus n. By our knowledge of exponents, we already know this. Now beautiful, this we already know, a plus b whole square, right? So what will this be? This is a plus b, and if I expand this particular identity, then it is nothing but a squared plus twice ab plus b square, right? Beautiful. Now what? Let's go for the expansion. So what will this be? This will be nothing but a times a square plus 2ab plus b squared, and then b, this is what we are using, is called distributive law, isn't it? So we are distributing the product. So hence now go for the kill. So what to do? Just multiply. So it is a cube plus 2a square b plus a times b squared, isn't it? A gets multiplied to all three of them. Similarly, here it will be a square b plus 2a b squared plus b cube. Mind you, I have written a before b. Some order is always good, isn't it? So hence, this will be the final expansion. But now, what we see is there are some like terms. So let's club these like terms and like terms. So hence, this will finally be a cube plus thrice a square b plus 3a b squared plus b cube. Now this looks awesome. Why? If you see, there's a great pattern which is visible over here. So if you observe the powers of a simply, so the powers of a is a cube here, a square, so it is reducing by 1 every time, isn't it? And simply, and similarly, if you see b, the powers are increasing 1 by 1, isn't it? Oh, that looks great. In fact, if you see later on when you'll study binomial theorem, you'll see even if a plus b is 10, you will see this kind of a pattern over there as well. Or for that matter, any power of any integral, positive integral power of a plus b, you'll see similar patterns. Now, one thing which is also very, you know, striking is the sum of the power is 3. If you see, sum of the powers is 3 always, isn't it? Always sum is 3. So hence, and what is this 3? This 3 is coming from this index, guys. Okay, so this is another way to, you know, keep a check on whether you have written the identity correctly or not. Now, and this 3 also appears here, so you can remember it very easily. So a cube plus thrice a square b plus thrice a b square plus b cube. Very good. Can we manipulate this? Mathematics, we have been manipulating expressions and, you know, twisting and turning and seeing it from different perspectives. So let us say this was a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. Now, if you notice, there are common terms in these two, isn't it? So what can this be? This can be written as a plus b cube is equal to a cube plus b cube. So I have clubbed this b cube with this a cube, powers together, they are like brothers. Now hence, after that, I am taking 3ab as common, and this becomes a plus b. Very, very good. So hence, if you see, a cube plus b cube, this one can be expressed as a plus b whole cube. This was on this side. And now, guys, let us take this beautiful looking factor on the other side. It will convert into minus and it will become a plus b. If you didn't understand, I would request you to pause the video and understand and then only proceed. So a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b whole cube minus 3ab a plus b. So this particular manifestation of this identity would be useful when, let us say, they would be giving the value of a plus b and they will be giving the value of ab, and they will ask you to find out the value of a cube plus b cube. So please keep this beautiful identity in your mind. Now, but we can't really stop here. If you see, we can go further. So if you see, I can take a plus b is common, and what is left within, I can see there is a plus b whole square minus 3ab. Wow. Now what? Let us expand the second bracket as well. If you see, this will be a squared plus 2ab plus b squared, isn't it? A plus b whole square is this. Now this has become, you know, this has gone into our blood now. A plus b whole square is a square plus 2ab plus b square minus 3ab, which was there here. So I have just written like that. Now you can see these are like terms again. So we love to combine like terms. So hence it will be a plus b a square minus ab plus b square. Oh my god, we have got another beautiful looking relationship. So a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b a square minus ab plus b square. Wow. So what did we learn so far in this session? So far we learned identity number one, a plus b whole cube is equal to a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. The same a plus b whole cube was manipulated and we wrote a cube plus b cube as a plus b whole cube minus 3ab a plus b, isn't it? And the third one which we learned was a cube plus b cube was given as a plus b times a square minus ab plus b square. If you notice, we have just factorized sum of two cubes. So hence, if someone gives you 6 cube plus 9 cube, let's say, then you can factorize this using this method, isn't it? Now look at some variations, right? What is variation? So let's say if I change b to minus b, what will this become? So I can write a minus, let us say I want to find a minus b whole cube. So what will this be? You already know it, that minus b can be written like this, isn't it? Now it reduces to our known identity, and let's expand it. So hence it is a cube plus 3a square times minus b plus 3a minus b square plus minus b cubed, isn't it? So hence what is the final result? If you see, a cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square minus b cubed. Okay, so if you see, wherever the power of b was odd, the sign got changed. Wow. So wherever the power of b was odd, the sign got changed. So if you see, here the power was odd, here the power of b was odd, and hence sign got changed. So hence this is what we got. It let us say if it was something like minus a plus b whole cube, then what would you do? Wherever the sign of a is odd, you can change that. So it will be finally minus a cube plus 3a square b, then what? Minus 3ab square and plus b cube, isn't it? Very easy. Similarly, the other two variants can also be written. So a cube plus b cube, so you can treat it as fourth. Fifth would be a cube plus b cube, and again, wherever the power of b is odd, you change that sign. So hence it is a minus b whole cube. And sorry, and we are here trying to find out a cube minus b cube, isn't it? Minus b cube. So hence it will be a minus b whole cube minus, or rather 3ab, because power of b here is odd, so you change the sign, and here it is a minus b. Beautiful. Now the sixth one is nothing but a cube minus b cube, and we are considering this one wherever the power of b is odd, because minus is attached to b. So wherever the power of b is odd, change the sign. Here it is odd, here it is odd, here it is even, here it is even. So you will not change this. Hence it is a minus b and a square plus ab plus D square. Fantastic. So hence, guys, you can now include these three and these six rather identities into the list of your algebraic identities. I suggested to you earlier as well, make a comprehensive list of algebraic identities at one place, and whenever you are solving problems, keep that list in front of you so that it becomes easier for you to solve the problems. Now, I would not recommend you to mug up any identity. Yeah, so the only way to remember identity is try solving as many problems as you can. That's the best way to learn and remember algebraic identities. Thank you, guys.